of Black Lives Matter protests, last month was also Indigenous History Month. It was also Pride Month, and these aren't mutually exclusive groups or movements. I believe we all have a lot of decolonization work to do, all of us. In one way or another, we've all been colonized, assimilated. I don't know about you, but something that I've learned to embrace is that I'm dangerous, wild even. To shake down systems of oppression is dangerous. Disruption is wild. I've felt a lot of coming home moments. I have felt closer to my ancestors than I have in a very long time. It's something I've always been aware of, but I'm learning to expect it again. And one thing I know for sure is that we must decolonize. Be wild. There were a few weeks where I was not sleeping well, I was having more anxiety than usual, and I know I'm not the only one. The uncertainty of this year, externally and internally, has been overwhelming. I really do have so much to be grateful for, but I can't deny that I feel stunned. That's the best word I can think of. Like, everything's shocking, but everything's also normal at the same time. I don't know if that makes sense. So many relationships with family, friends, even with myself has come into question. And that's a lot. Navigating what every new day looks like is a lot. I also feel like I've made a lot of people upset lately, and I'm pretty okay with it. The thing is, a lot of people have made me upset too. I've called white supremacy out in people, but also I've been pointing to amazing human beings with incredible resources. And I'm really happy to be doing both, honestly. I've gotten angry, I've gotten really sad, I've also gotten really inspired and excited. And that's usually all before 10 a.m. I've dealt with loss, I've gotten in fights, I've gained new perspective and new goals. Honestly, I've been all over the map. And I really have no other expectation for myself than that. I am getting good at confrontation and I like that, but I'm also still sensitive. Maybe that's my Pisces rising. And I truly do expect the best out of everyone, sometimes naively so. And that's what I mostly see. I see the best. I lean towards, you know, the cup being half full. When I get let down or disappointed, I feel that shit in my soul. I feel it really hard. I'm learning to let that be okay. Being angry and then motivated is okay. Being inspired and then sad is okay. I'm okay with this. Now, to all my fellow activists, hear me out. It's okay to be tired. You've been shouting and running around, feeling all the feels. It's okay to be tired. Our work will never be done. I get that. But we can't keep holding our eyes open with clothespins. You need rest. We aren't going to run out of people to teach and inspire and to call out. We aren't going to run out of ways within even ourselves to keep growing and learning and decolonizing. It is lifelong, boo-boo. But oh my God, you need rest. I need rest. I don't know what that looks like for you. Turning off your phone for the day, that doesn't mean you gave up. You are resting. Deleting certain apps, so on and so forth. Taking a moment isn't turning a blind eye. It's resting a very bloodshot, weepy, weary, exhausted eye. There is really so much to be active about right now. But look around. You aren't alone. You aren't holding the world up by yourself. I know it feels like it, but there's so many of us. Take a moment, heal yourself. If you're like me, you've been hurt, wounded, and you need to address those wounds. What good are you if you just bleed out on the battlefield? Activists, be good to you. Goodness starts with you. In you. I also want to note, to be very clear, this is for activists. For the people who've already moved on or couldn't handle the negativity, just so you know, you are part of the problem. You are part of what's absolutely draining the rest of us. We see you. We don't feel like it's okay to rest because you checked out too early. Some of you never even checked in at all. Fix yourself. So, I tend to focus on what is right in front of me. So I look for things that bring me peace or joy in the moment, like repotting plants, studying religions, listening to podcasts, enjoying being in my head. I'm an Enneagram 5, if you know the Enneagram. I like being in my head. And you know, something interesting, as I was learning and I'm studying religions, like unofficially, I'm not like taking some course, but I'm looking into religions. And it's interesting because with each religion, I feel like there is always some main purpose or like focus that each religion has. And I think one of Jesus's main focuses within activism was one of inclusion, radical inclusion. It's crazy how much Christianity has manipulated that over time to where it seems like Christianity's focus is quite opposite of that. Anyway, it's really fun to study religions without an agenda, without fear, or really any other expectation besides knowledge. It's quite inspiring, actually. I highly recommend it. I really got nothing but love for you guys. And I hope you hear that. I hope you feel that. Better days are on their way. Go drink something delicious. Have a dance party to your favorite music. Buy a plant. Listen to podcasts. Watch some shows. There is light everywhere. Because light is wherever you are. You are magic. Never forget it. Bye, guys.